speaker is John O'Grady from Perfinity.
All right, so I'm here to talk to you about a product that we actually released last year. I'm John O'Grady, I'm from Perfinity, and I want to talk about next generation protein sample preparation. And I took a little hint from the internet, and I was told this was supposed to be entertaining. So as anybody who has spent any time on the internet, basically ever, knows, the best way to hold somebody's attention for 2 to 3 hours is to give them pictures of cats. So, but really, I'm here to talk about Flash Digest and what Flash Digest does. It's an immobilized trypsin resin that is thermally stable, that gives you very rapid digestion with uncompromising results. And here we have kittens who are interested in their insulin levels. But what do I mean when I say rapid digestion? I mean we're taking something that was a 24-hour digestion of insulin, according to a typical protocol, and we're doing it in 4 minutes. And this is, yes, this is purified protein, but if we do something like thyroglobulin and plasma, we can take a 20-hour protocol, an overnight method, do it in 4 hours, and we can get double the signal of the best peptide of that method and get 100-fold better signal on some of the less of our slower generated peptides. And we've done this for a lot of different proteins now. Last year we just released it, but now we've got a lot of experience. We've seen it over and over and over again. And it doesn't matter if you're working in plasma or if you're working with meat proteins. We can digest it. Here we have PK Cat. He's very, very interested in his IgGs. But what do I mean when I say uncompromising results? Trypsin can be a fickle mistress. Yes, we can add more trypsin and we can get faster digestions. But at some point you start to run into issues when you start loading in the trypsin. It loves to chew up any proteins, and unfortunately is a protein. So it will chew on itself, and then it will go back after it's chewed on itself, and it will continue to chew on your protein, and not in the nice specific way you're used to. And so you end up losing a lot of your signal as you add in more trypsin because of this autolysis and this chymotrophic digestion. So what do we do? Oh, I forgot. We have Clinical Cat who wants to watch his ApoA1 level. So what do we do? How do we fix these problems? Well, the first thing we do is we use immobilization of trypsin, and this helps prevent autolysis. But we don't just immobilize a little trypsin. We immobilize a lot of trypsin, and this helps push our reactions forward very rapidly. And then we also use thermal acceleration, denaturation, so that according to the Arrhenius rate law, we are going orders of magnitude faster, and we can skip preparatory steps because the heat will denature our proteins and make those tryptic cleavage sites accessible anyways. So in the end, we have a product that gives you that rapid digestion and uncompromising results. And with that, I would like to leave you with an adorable picture of a cat wearing the Flash costume.
Thank you very much. Very nice.